On May 29, 2021, it has been 10 years since my sister, Vivian Mestey Wolfe, passed away and went to heaven with Jesus Christ. I could tell you that that journey has been truly the hardest that my family has walked through. Vivian was my best friend. Vivian was my everything. Vivian, I didn't have friends. I didn't need friends. I had her. She fulfilled me. And it was the same way for her. We just had each other. So you could imagine the pain that I went through when I actually lost that person. Vivian was an amazing aunt to my daughter. She was a second mom. She was, Vivian and Christine will always be at their house. She was always with her. She would do her hair. She was a wonderful sister to my husband, a wonderful daughter. My mom and dad has suffered so much. My dad still suffers. He can't really see pictures with Vivian or even be part of this. He's just, his heart is just completely broken. And once a month, he still goes to the cemetery to visit her. It's really hard to see how my mom and dad has suffered the loss of my sister. On her deathbed, Vivian asked me to please be the mother she knew that Christopher would need on earth. And it has been an incredible journey raising her son. And I know that she looks down upon us and is truly proud of who we have all become since she has departed. Vivian came to this world to change it. She changed my life by being part of it. She touched my daughter's life. She was just amazing. And I keep saying it. The only way I could describe my sister is by saying that she was amazing, because she was. I will forever love her. She will forever be in my heart. And she will be there until I meet with her again in heaven. And then we'll have eternity with each other. And we will never have to say goodbye. These 10 years have taught us that life is short. That life is hard. But it is a life that I want to live, because that meant that she was part of it. And I hope you guys enjoy this beautiful memorial that we are doing for her.
Hi, this is Vivian. Vivian Christine, mom. Growing up, I always would think and daydream that I would get married and have some children. And later on in life, I did get married. And God blessed me with my firstborn child. That was my first girl, Vivian Christine. To be able to be called a mom, you either have to have a son or a daughter. And I have the honor and the privilege to call Vivian Christine my daughter, Vivita. Vivita was so special. It's been, she always was a blessing for our family. She was so good to each one of us here. Everybody was so special for her. She grew up being a very formal, young, special lady. She was very strict. She was very firm in her convictions. I could be talking about her and Vivian was. But beside all that, Vivian was a very happy person, very kind person, very joyful. She loved to laugh. She loved to dance. She loved to plan trips. She loved to plan vacations. She was always in the computer, putting down group tours. Whenever we'll go to any place, she already had it all developed. One thing that was curious that I noticed about her, and it always impressed me, that it didn't matter where we would go or where we would stay, she would always be sure that there was a Catholic church nearby, because she will not miss Sunday Mass. And that showed me the value and the principles and the faith that Vivian had in her convictions through her faith, and that she knew that holding on to Jesus' hands is the only way really to live in life and walk in life. She had she was happiness for the house. Everybody was just so joyful when she was around. She was very, but don't get her mad, because she did have a temper. But she was really good, but don't get her mad. as we're growing up in teenagers, well, I had to be their best friends. So if we would see a nice looking guy and we didn't want him to, or she didn't see him, or I saw him and she didn't notice him, I would say, or Vianas would say, "Ea rayo." So every time we would see a handsome guy, we would go, "Ea rayo." So we knew what it was, and immediately we would turn around and look for the "Ea rayo." So that was like saying, "Oh my goodness, you know, holy moly, look at that." So that was us together. We were always laughing. We love to eat out. And then came her boyfriend, of course, Bill. He was a very big part of her life, because out of that love, she had her baby boy, Christopher, which Christopher is 18 years old today. And she will be so proud of him, of who he has become. He's very special. He's very good. He's just like his mom, like a really clear white soul. He's just a good person. And going back to all the things that the girls will do together, they will wait every Thursday to see friends. Oh my goodness, they wouldn't miss that for nothing. They would see friends, they would do popcorns, and that was part of their routine, weekly routine. Then later on in life came the Golden Girls. So that was all about jokes and things about, and they would name each other, because, you know, they would try to go into characters with the girls that were in the Golden Girls. So, well, not girls, the ladies. But in total, the only thing I could say is we have learned how to live without her. We have learned without seeing her physically. We have learned that this is reality. But we have learned that she was loved, that we loved her so much, that she knows her, that we loved her so much, that she is so loved, that she's very missed, that every moment, every day, every hour, every moment, every second, I think of her. Now it's going to be 10 years, so it seems even more than 10 years for me as a mom. But when we talk about her, now we can like refer to her as a joke, or Vivian used to say this, or Vivian used to say that. And now it's like more acceptable, if you could say that. But the only way that we could get through all this is because I walk with Jesus and his blessed mother. And they're the only ones that could hold my hand and give me the peace, the courage, and the strength to keep going for my family, for my daughter, my grandkids, my husband, my family in total. And she will be very proud to hear all the comments that we know that you guys are going to have towards her. May God bless you all. Take care. Bye-bye.
I truly am honored to have had her as my mom. I couldn't have asked for a better one. She was a very kind, sweet, loving, giving, wonderful person overall. And I hate to say this, but I really don't remember much about her. What I do remember her doing was making rosaries, sitting on the couch watching TV, making rosaries. What else? I remember on Halloween, I was a fireman. My mom and dad dressed up as Dalmatians, and I remember putting the makeup on her face, and just the atmosphere was so full of love between them. Then another occasion I remember multiple times of her tucking me into bed and praying in bed when I was real young. And I also remember going to somewhere, I don't exactly remember where it was, but going somewhere and feeding ducks. She made that always fun to look forward to doing. Then another thing I remember is, I kind of laugh thinking about it now, is we were in the Outer Banks and I fell off a bunk bed I remember how why I fell off the bunk bed, but I fell off. And she came running in to the room. She was the first one into the room, and that's when she was sick. Like that's what that she was sick at that time, and she was the first one in the room. And then I remember other occasions watching America's Funniest Home Videos while we ate dinner. This is really all I can say I remember about her. And I know it's really sad for me to think about that. She won't be able to go to Halloween with us when we go to Disney. And she won't go to my wedding. She won't see my kids. Hurts to think about, but it is what it is. And I heard I was too young to remember her. I blocked it out, but people told me that she fought hard to stay alive. And I will always have her in my heart forever. I love her to death. Can't wish she was still here. And that's pretty much all I have to say about her. I love her.
For me, Titi will always be somebody very, very special to me. When she was here, we did about almost everything together. If there was a new movie in the movie theater, she would come to my house, she'd pick me up, she'd take me, and on the drive home, we would talk about what was our favorite part or what character we liked the most. It was one thing I enjoyed the most doing with her was going to the movie theaters or just walking around the mall. Anything I did with her was always so much fun, and it always sticks out to me in my memories. Even though it's been 10 years, it doesn't make her loss any easier. I can't believe it's been 10 years. I miss her a lot. I think about her every day. Certain songs come up, and I think about her, and it makes me miss her. But one thing that helps with missing her is all these good, fantastic memories that I have of her. Like the way she would hug me, the way she would brush my hair, the way that I would go over to her house a few times a week, and we would have crescent rolls with dinner, and we would watch America's Funniest Home Videos. And those memories, they stick out to me. They have stayed with me close to my heart these 10 years, and there won't be a day that goes by I won't think about her.
The things I remember about Vivian. She was a very dedicated wife. She loved Bill like crazy and would do anything for him. She was also an awesome mom to Christopher, so tender and loving in every way with him. As far as a sister to Vianlex, she was always there, always looking out for her, always protecting her, like a big sister should. She was a crazy about Vianlex Christine, her Titi. Treated her the same love and tenderness and compassion as she treated Christopher. She treated me like a brother. We loved, we fought, like brother and sister. And I always remember the one phrase that still sticks in my head today. Excuse me? And those that were there remember why. She was always strong, fearless, and always had a brave face. Never let us see her in pain or suffer in any way. She hid it very well. 10 years ago. Still miss her so much. I know she's looking down on us, patiently waiting for us. On the day that we get to see each other again. In our eternal heaven.
Vivian's marriage was a chapter in her life that was just beautiful. She was so lucky in love. Her and her husband were meant for each other. They were like two souls that God made that were perfect for each other. And when they found each other, their love was just astonishing. They loved each other. They never fought. They never were unhappy. Their love was so big. But that's also, I believe, one reason why Christopher is the way he is, because he was conceived with so much love. And he represents that love that my sister was lucky enough to walk on this earth with. Her husband was truly an amazing husband. And when she got sick at 29 years old, he just hold her hand and walk her through that journey. And it was a journey that it was both of them. And he never let go of her hand until the last breath that she took on this earth. And I feel like she was so lucky that God blessed her with such a beautiful love. Many people don't find that type of love, and they're still searching for it. And she found it, and it was just beautiful to see her happy and have a beautiful marriage. She also was very blessed with her mother-in-law. You know, she loved Lois very much, and it was mutual. And they would go on vacations together, and every Saturday they would go see each other. You know, Bill would take her to see her his mom and dad. And she was just, in that aspect, Vivian was fulfilled. She really was. She had a wonderful marriage and a wonderful family that came with the marriage, that included her mother-in-law and father-in-law. And I'm just so glad that Christopher could look up to the type of marriage that his parents had, so he could follow that example in his own life when he finds love.
I met Vivian when we were going to start kindergarten. I remember visiting the school one day and she was there. That is my only memory of that day. We were playing together around the school. She was my first friend there. From that day until she moved, we were very close. I have so many lovely memories of us spending time together, celebrating birthdays, spending vacation days together, having sleepovers, even visiting her grandparents' house. We did all kind of different fun activities at her house. I was lucky to have known her when we were growing up. I really wish I could have spent time with her as an adult, see her one more time. She was a very special lady.
Hola, Vivi. Este mensaje es para ti, entre medio de los coquís, entre medio de la isla donde naciste, donde tengo tantos recuerdos de ti. Te puedo decir que nuestra niñez fue espectacular. Nadamos, gozamos, wow, nuestras navidades eran espectaculares. Nuestra juventud quizás fue en los Estados Unidos, pero gozamos igual. Teti, eres única, sigue siendo única. Mi hija me acuerda muchísimo de ti, su alegría, sus risos, ese entusiasmo único. Esa eras tú. Te puedo decir que pienso muchísimo, muchísimo en ti, porque la tengo a ella, no tan solo por eso, nuestros recuerdos de niñez. Aquí en este balcón donde estoy, te puedo decir que te extrañamos muchísimo. Wow, en estos últimos semanas te puedo decir que he soñado muchísimo contigo. Y que eras única. Tu carácter era único. Eras alegre, eras entusiasta. Eras una pelota de felicidad. Y te extraño muchísimo, no tan solo yo, pero mi hija. Gracias a ella me es the resemblance of you. I love you and we miss you very, very, very much. I love you, Vivi.
Buenas, Vivita. ¿Cuánto tiempo sin poder verte, sin poder saber de ti? Pero alegrada porque sé que estás con el Señor y la Madre en el cielo. Qué linda fuiste cuando vivías al lado aquí de mi casa, que eras una pretín y natín, que ibas al mismo colegio de mis hijos. Qué alegría tan grande cuando fui a visitarte a la casa de Woodford.
allá donde ustedes vivían a la primera, y me quedaba en el cuarto de Vivian, pero nos reuníamos las cuatro en ese cuarto a chacharear como si fuéramos cuatro amigas. Qué emoción tan grande cuando recibí tu deseo de que yo fuese la madrina en tu boda. Fueron muchas alegrías las que me diste, Vivita. Siempre llenaste mi corazón. Eras siempre tan delicada. Siempre fuiste tan respetuosa. Y no sabes cuánto te quise, hija mía. Pero el Señor tenía preparado para ti mansiones celestiales que ojalá nosotros todos podamos tener y poder compartir contigo. Espero que estés recibiendo las gracias de Jesús y de María allá en el cielo. Al igual que nosotros deseamos poder seguir aquí tus pasos para poder encontrarnos un día contigo. Todo mi amor para ti, mi vida. Sabes que siempre te querré montón de montones. To be continued, my dear. Bye.
I remember Vivian as a very kind friend, sister, daughter, and just human being in general. She was one of those people that really did put others first before herself. You know, I distinctly remember just how incredibly kind and generous she was with her sister, Vianlix. She always seemed to have her in her mind's eye when we were, you know, as a group of friends, if we went somewhere. She always seemed to be looking outward rather than inward, and specifically seemed to most times to be looking at her sister and just making sure that she was taken care of and feeling comfortable and having a good time. The other thing that I noticed was that she, you know, these qualities just continued as, you know, and later in life. I noticed that when, you know, when she had a family, she was very kind to her son and her husband, and her sister seemed to raise the kids as just one solid family, which I always thought was amazing. So just in general, I always just remember Vivian as just one of those kind people you meet in your life who makes a distinct mark in terms of thinking of someone who really does try to live her life in the way that Christ would have you live your life to others. And I know that she's well taken care of now that she's in heaven.
Viviancita, no tengo palabras que le escriban la falta que me hace, pero me consuelo al saber que algún día te volveré a ver. Te quiero mucho. Dios te bendiga. Jupiteres.
Hello, my name is Grisel, and I'm the cousin of Vivian and Vianlix. Vianlix asked me to record some memories that we had when we were children with my cousin Vivian, or mi primita bella preciosa, like we used to call her, Vivita. So, of course, I said yes, I will definitely share some memories. The problem is that I have so many memories of our childhood that I'm gonna try to be short and just share a couple. So one memory that comes to my mind when we were children and we were very, very small, however, is incredible because I still think about it often, and it always makes me laugh. And this was a game we used to play at my grandparents' house, Abuela Julia y Abuelo Felix. We used to basically jump from bed to bed. We would be there for hours while my grandmother would chase us because, of course, we were breaking her beds. All I remember was that we used to call this game Socorrito, but I can't remember what was the game, what was the purpose, who won, who will lose. The only thing I can say is that every time that memory comes in my mind, I just feel joy and happiness. This is how I used to feel every time I was around my cousin Vivian. And I'm sure that is something that we all share, everybody that spend time with her would share this, that when you were around her physically, you will feel this joy or peace or happiness, just, you know, relax and you can be yourself always. I remember these feelings since we were little kids. Other memories that I have, it was Christmas. Christmas was huge for us. I used to get very excited about spending Christmas with my cousins, Vivian and Bianlix. And again, it was always pure joy, happiness. I never forget that we used to play at my aunt and uncle's house in the waterbed. Those are memories that I will cherish my whole life. Then we grew up, and we were living far, but we always kept connected. I remember our conversations. However, the conversation that I will never forget was when Vivian called me to tell me that she was expecting and she was pregnant with Christopher. She was so happy. That was a beautiful, beautiful moment that we had now as grown-ups and adults. I admire my cousin a lot. I admire my cousin Vivian a lot. I'm gonna get emotional. But I do, I admire her, some of the things that I admire her and that I try to emulate actually from her nowadays is the love and kindness that she always showed toward other people, even people that she didn't know well, even toward strangers. Also, the dedication that she had with family. And Vivian was always very genuine. She really never tried to impress anybody. She was herself. She was Vivian. And I always admired that a lot. Her faith, her gigantic faith that she always had. She taught me a lot about that. I miss her a lot. I miss specifically her love, her laughter. It was so contagious. So I do miss her a lot physically. I know she is around us all the time, and it's amazing because nowadays, anytime I get busy and I start disconnecting with family or life circumstances make me doubt my faith, I can feel her. I can feel her around me, grounding me. And I will always be grateful for that because I feel I'm not alone. I feel she's around. So I didn't want to make a long recording. I love you, Vivian. I love you very much. I wish I can give you a physical hug. I know I can't, but we can connect in other ways. And I love you, and I miss you, and I'm so glad we're doing this. I can't wait to see what Bianlix does with all her talent, and I know that you're so proud of her. And that's it. I love you guys. Thank you.
'Cause I'm dreaming of you.